Hey there, welcome to another episode of Coding with CodeCat. This is Ravi. कोई भी नया कॉन्सेप्ट जब निकलता है तो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू डू अ कंपैरिजन बिटवीन द ओल्ड वे ऑफ डूइंग थिंग्स वर्सेस द न्यू वे ऑफ डूइंग थिंग्स एंड इन दिस सेशन वी आर डूइंग एक्जैक्टली द सेम सो दिस इज द प्रैग्मेटिक इंट्रोडक्शन टू स्विफ्ट यूआई. आज के सेशन में जो प्रेजेंटेशन और कोड यूज होगा वो ऑलरेडी गिटहब और गूगल ड्राइव पे अपडेटेड है एंड इफ यू नीड द कोड व्हाट यू कैन डू इज यू कैन चेक द वीडियो डिस्क्रिप्शन क्लिक ऑन द लिंक एंड डाउनलोड द कोड एंड प्रेजेंटेशन फॉर यू. नाउ बिफोर वी बिगिन विद दिस सेशन आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट if you're liking the work that I'm doing, if you're learning something from my videos, then I would request you to please subscribe to the channel and share it with your iOS group. That being said, let's begin our today's session. In this session, we're going to talk about Swift UI. And these are the topics that we're going to cover. That is, what is Swift UI, when to use it, some frequently asked questions, and a demo. But before we begin with this session, here are some words of wisdom. A good UI with an ugly unstructured code base is an insult to the UI and to the project. Now, what I mean by this is many times developers, what they do is their focus is so sharp in building an excellent UI ki wo apne code pe dhyan nahi dete. या फिर उनका thinking ऐसा होता है कि कैसे भी करके ये functionality end कर दो क्योंकि लोग तो UI देखते हैं, code कोई नहीं देखता. But what if your client decides कि third party review करना है आपके code का, या फिर what if you have a technical client who has a coding background जो एक दिन ये decide करता है कि आपके साथ बैठ कर उसको code review करना है. How confident are you with the current code base if such things ever happen? And if you're not confident about your own code, then this means that your code is not following any design principles and coding standards. To all developers who think ki UI acha bana do aur code kaise bhi kar do bas functionality khatam karo, I have a question, and perhaps this is the same question that I have asked in my past videos. What if you have a car with a beautiful exterior but uska interior low quality material ka bana hua hai? You will not think about purchasing this car because it has no value for money. There is a reason why client do third party code reviews, and this is to check the interior of the project, which is code quality. And code quality only comes when you are following coding standards and design principles. ऐसा नहीं है कि code Stack Overflow से उठाया, paste कर दिया project में और दूसरे task में चले गए. I have a video on this, that is why you want to become a tech lead, and I would request every fresher and every senior developer to watch that video. You can also watch that video by clicking on the I button on the top right hand side corner. I think now you might have understood कि UI is not everything. हमें code करते वक्त performance, maintenance और code clarity point of view से भी सोचना होगा. Now this is something that I have always said in my videos, and I hope ki is thought ko aapne implement bhi kiya hoga apne projects mein. Now let us talk about what is Swift UI. Swift UI is Apple's declarative way of building user interfaces from iOS 13 onwards. Now I have used the word declarative. Iska kya matlab hai main thodi der mein samjhaunga. Aap Swift UI use karke kisi bhi iOS device, Mac ya tvOS ke liye UI bana sakte ho. Right now, how we make UI is more instruction-based, and such an approach is called as imperative. Now, let me give you an example to explain more on what I mean by instruction-based or imperative. हम लोगों ने कभी ना कभी पिज़्ज़ा तो ऑर्डर किया ही होगा लाइफ में, और पिज़्ज़ा ऑर्डर करते वक्त हम बहुत ही स्पेसिफिक इंस्ट्रक्शन देते हैं कि पिज़्ज़ा की टॉपिंग्स कौन सी होनी चाहिए, बेस कौन सा होना चाहिए, चीज़ कौन सा होना चाहिए, मोज़रेला या पार्मेशन. सो द इंस्ट्रक्शन विच आर गिवन आर वेरी स्पेसिफिक एंड डिटेल. वी विल लुक इन टू अ स्मॉल एग्जाम्पल एज वेल टू एक्सप्लेन दिस मोर इन जस्ट अ फ्यू मिनट्स. Every control has a IB action and IB outlet to manage state and events in the imperative approach, jo ab filhal hum log kar rahe hain. Now, with Swift UI, the interface becomes more smart, which is a declarative approach. So now it's time to explain what declarative means. And for that, let me give you the same example. Aap pizza order karte ho aur bolte ho ki mujhe veg pizza khana hai, ya fir let us say aap bolte ho mujhe farm fresh pizza khana hai, that's it. Aap detail mein kuch nahi bolte. And just with this one piece of information is enough to get the final result. आपने कोई यहाँ डिटेल में नहीं बताया कि आपको टॉपिंग्स क्या चाहिए, चीज़ कौन सा चाहिए. जस्ट वन पीस ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन वॉज इनफ टू गेट द फाइनल रिजल्ट. अनदर एग्जाम्पल कुड बी आपके पेरेंट्स आपको कोल्ड ड्रिंक लाने को बोलते हैं. उन्होंने ये नहीं बोला है आपको कि कौन सी दुकान से लाना है. कोई डिटेल इंस्ट्रक्शन यहाँ पे नहीं मिला है आपको. एट द एंड ऑफ द डे यू गो टू द शॉप एंड ब्रिंग द कोल्ड ड्रिंक. सच अप्रोचेस वेर जस्ट वन पीस ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन इज इनफ टू गेट द फाइनल रिजल्ट विदाउट एनी डिटेल इज कॉल्ड डिक्लेरेटिव अप्रोच. Now let us say declarative and imperative approach are something that you're hearing for the first time and you liked how I explained them, then please do give a like and subscribe to the channel. We can add rules on the controls and Swift UI make sure that those rules are followed. Now this is the power of declarative syntax that Swift UI provides. Aap aapke UI ko specific instruction dete ho and Swift UI make sure that those instructions are implemented. We will soon see this in a simple demo that we will build today to understand the difference between imperative and declarative ways of making UI. When to use Swift UI. Now this is very important to understand. जो भी iOS project projects हैं दे टारगेट सम सर्टन रेंज ऑफ ओएस. एग्जाम्पल, क्लाइंट आपका बोलेगा कि ये ऐप जो है वो iOS 10 से लेके iOS के लेटेस्ट वर्जन को सपोर्ट करना चाहिए, और यहाँ पे आपके सारे सपने टू यूज़ स्विफ्ट UI टूट जाते हैं, बिकॉज स्विफ्ट UI जो है वो iOS 13 से अवेलेबल है. तो आप स्विफ्ट UI को यूज़ नहीं कर सकते ऐसे प्रोजेक्ट्स में. सो एक कंडीशन है कि स्विफ्ट UI को यूज़ करने के लिए, और वो कंडीशन ये है कि आपका क्लाइंट ये बोलना चाहिए कि आप जो ऐप बना रहे हो वो सिर्फ iOS 13 एंड अबो पे रन होना चाहिए. एंड ऐसा नहीं है कि एप्पल तुरंत कोई नया मेजर वर्जन रिलीज़ करता है. एप्पल टेक्स अराउंड 8 to 10 months और समटाइम्स इवन एन ईयर टू रिलीज मेजर iOS वर्जन. एंड मे बी ओनली टाइम विल टेल इफ एप्पल अलाउज यू नो लाइक स्विफ्ट UI टू बी बैकवर्ड कंपैटिबल एंड सपोर्ट ओल्डर iOS वर्जन, या फिर वी हैव टू वेट टिल एप्पल डिसकंटिन्यूज द सपोर्ट फॉर iOS 12, एंड दैट कुड डेफिनेटली टेक टाइम. नाउ मूविंग ऑन, स्टोरीबोर्ड और XIB का सपोर्ट इतना जल्दी नहीं जाएगा क्योंकि बहुत से ऐप्स का UI आज भी उन्हीं में बना हुआ है. एंड ऐसे ऐप्स में अगर मेंटेनेंस रिक्वेस्ट आई या फिर कोई चेंज रिक्वेस्ट आए तो उस केस में भी आप स्विफ्ट UI का यूज़ नहीं कर पाओगे. नाउ दिस रिमाइंड्स मी इन जून 2014 जब स्विफ्ट रिलीज हुआ था तो सब ये बोलने लगे थे कि एप्पल ऑब्जेक्टिव सी का सपोर्ट बंद कर देगा, बट ऑलमोस्ट 6 साल हो गए उस बात को और आज भी आप ऑब्जेक्टिव सी में प्रोजेक्ट्स बना सकते हो. एंड देर आर मेनी प्रोजेक्ट्स विच स्टिल यूज ऑब्जेक्टिव सी, एंड एप्पल हैज नॉट डिसकंटिन्यूड द सपोर्ट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्टिव सी बिकॉज ऑफ द वेरी सेम रीजन. क्योंकि सभी डेवलपर्स अब एक रेस में लग गए हैं, द रेस इज टू लर्न स्विफ्ट UI, और प्रोजेक्ट से अच्छी चीज़ तो कोई हो ही नहीं सकती इंप्लीमेंटेशन के लिए. नाउ आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड इन थिंक बिफोर यूजिंग अ थर्ड पार्टी वीडियो की क्लाइंट प्रोजेक्ट्स आपके एक्सपेरिमेंट्स के लिए नहीं है. सो प्लीज डू नॉट यूज देम टू लर्न समथिंग न्यू, बिकॉज आपके सीखने के चक्कर में प्रोजेक्ट्स डिले हो सकते हैं. एंड नॉट ओनली दैट, इट्स एन अनप्रोफेशनल एटीट्यूड टू डू समथिंग लाइक दिस. एक सेपरेट प्रोजेक्ट बनाए और आप वहाँ पे स्विफ्ट UI सीख सकते हो, या फिर क्लाइंट प्रोजेक्ट की जो फंक्शनैलिटी आपको करनी है वो आप अपने सैम्पल प्रोजेक्ट्स में बना सकते हो. सो डोंट यूज क्लाइंट प्रोजेक्ट्स एज योर स्टेपिंग स्टोन टू लर्न समथिंग न्यू. Now let's have a look at some other FAQs. Are there any restrictions on using Swift UI? Well, the only restriction I can think of is your apps needs to be targeted from iOS 13 onwards. That's the only restriction I can think of. Do I have to use Swift UI for all my projects from now on? Is question ka answer dene ke liye hame Swift UI ki definition ko samajhna hoga, and the definition is build user interfaces across Apple platform with the power of Swift. Now looking at the definition, I think if my client demands that he will be using the same user interface for iOS devices and Mac desktop applications, then using Swift UI makes more sense. Else, using storyboards and XIB should be okay if you're not going to target multiple platform of the Apple ecosystem. One thing everybody needs to understand is that Apple has not made it compulsory to use Swift UI. They are just providing a flexible option ki agar aapko Mac, iOS ke liye apps banana hai, to you can use Swift UI. Else आप स्टोरीबोर्ड या XIB यूज कर सकते हो. Apple is not going to reject your applications if you are not using Swift UI. I think Apple हमें एक नए डायरेक्शन में लेके जा रहे हैं with regards to making UI, and making UI in Swift UI is amazingly fast as compared to storyboards. Now let us say if the client says कि मुझे उसका जो नया एप्लीकेशन है, the client wants it to be targeted from iOS 13 onwards. So I would choose Swift UI because of the declarative way, and my technical reason for that is मुझे मेरे UI को स्मार्ट बनाने के लिए ज़्यादा कोड नहीं लिखना होगा. एंड अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स जिसके लिए आप कोड लिखते थे पहले, दैट कैन बी सिंप्लीफाइड विद द हेल्प ऑफ Swift UI विद फ्यू लाइंस ऑफ कोड. व्हाट इफ आई वांट टू यूज Swift UI फॉर एन एक्जिस्टिंग ऐप? वेल, एज आई सेड, इफ योर एप्स आर टारगेटेड फ्रॉम iOS 13 एंड अबव, यू कैन यूज Swift UI, एल्स नॉट. सो दिस मीन्स नो XIB और स्टोरीबोर्ड्स. वेल, आई वुड से नो, बिकॉज जिस तरीके से एप्पल ने ऑब्जेक्टिव सी का सपोर्ट बंद नहीं किया है, I think storyboards and XIB will be there for few years because aapke apps aaj bhi storyboard aur XIB ka use kar rahe hain. But yes, if you're using Swift UI, then there are no IB outlets, no IB actions, no storyboards, no XIB. I hope this answer does bring a smile on your face, and if it does, then please do like and subscribe to the channel. Now it's finally the demo time. So in the demo today, we are going to see the imperative and declarative way of creating UI. So the demo will be very simple today, just introduction, because detailed videos pe kaam chalu hai. And in the coming weeks, there will be few videos on how to do things with Swift UI, along with few other topics. My plans with Swift UI is not to release too many videos, but just some basic videos that should get you started. And jaise hi aap request karoge for some specific things in Swift UI, I will be very much happy to release videos on that specific requirement. So that being said, let's begin our demo. So let me escape the presentation and let me switch to Xcode. So this is the imperative UI demo, and in order to explain what we are doing in this demo, let me switch to the storyboard. So over here you have a text field and a login button, and the requirement is ki agar is text field mein 4 se zyada characters hai, to in that case this login button should be enabled, otherwise it should remain disabled. So let me just go ahead and run this and show it to you what I mean. So over here you can see that the login button is disabled, and the requirement is ki agar is text field mein, let us say 1 2 3 4 4 characters hai ya 4 se zyada hai, So in that case, what should happen is this login button should be enabled. So for that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump back to my view controller and I'm going to make use of the UI text field delegate. And I'm going to say, I have to use the text field chain selection. Ye wala hum log delegate function use karenge. And over here, what I'm going to say, ki if the text field ka jo text hai, uska jo count hai, if it is, let us say, greater than or equals to 4, then in that case, what should happen is my button should be enabled. But yahan pe abhi ek problem hai. Actually, two problem hai. The first is ki hum logon ne button ke liye koi IP outlet nahi banaya. And the second is I'm getting an error over here. So what I'm going to do to fix this first is, let me just wrap it. And right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make an IP outlet for the button. So I would say IP outlet weak var, and this is button login of the type UI button. And next thing what I'm going to do is I'm going to select my storyboard. And I would say that this button login is this guy. I'm going to save it. And over here, I'll say self.buttonLogin.isEnabled is equals to true. Varna usko hum log false hi rakhenge. So I would say self.buttonLogin.isEnabled is equals to false. And over here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to print a message. Let us say debug print, and I would say button login tapped. So let me just run this and see what we get. So over here, the button is disabled, it is not enabled. And let me just print my name. So over here, you can see the button is enabled again. And let me just remove this. And you can see the button is disabled. And when I tap on this, you can see BTN login is tapped. So over here, you can see kis tarike se hum log ne requirement fulfill karne ke liye we have used the text field delegate, and inside the delegate, we have given some specific piece of instructions ki what should be the condition jahan pe mera button enable or disable hona chahiye. So what we are going to do is we are going to have a look at the Shift UI example of the same version. So I would say file, new project, single view app. Aur yahan pe instead of user interface as storyboard, you can just click this and you can select Shift UI. And I would say Swift UI demo. And I would press next. And I would say create. And I would say resume. Now, this is a very cool feature of Swift UI. Now, over here on the right hand side, you can see ki kuch ek simulator jaisa view hai, which is a preview. Aur yahan pe the text is says hello world, which is same printed over here. So, yahan pe Swift UI mein ek advantage aisa hai ki aap jo bhi aapke UI ke liye code karoge. At the same time, what is going to happen is you are going to see ki wo UI dikhta kaise, and accordingly you can make adjustment. Now, for example, ye jo text hai, agar let us say mujhe iska font increase karna, so what I can do is I can just say font and I can say large title. So when I change this to large title, you can see at the same time yahan pe bhi mujhe wo change reflected dikha, to I can get an idea ki ye jo text hai ye kaisa dikhega mere device pe. So right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a text field and a button, and you don't have to worry about the syntax because that is something which I will be teaching in the upcoming sessions. And this is just to show you ki jo example hum logon ne storyboards ke saath kiya tha, wo same example Swift UI ke saath agar aap karte ho to aapko kitna code likhna padta hai. So what I'm going to do is I would say let me create a usse bhi pehle let me create some space. Perfect. To abhi main kya karunga, I am going to use a state private var name, and I would say this is of the type string, and that is equals to, I would say string. And over here, what I would say is I'm going to use vstack, and let me comment this guy out. Aur yahan pe, I will be creating a text field over here. And the text field is going to have a title. Title is more or less like a placeholder. So I would say username. Or ye jo text hai, I am going to bind it with this variable over here. So I would say dollar name. And now the only thing that is pending is to create a button. Now you must be thinking ki yahan pe, humara UI kyun nahi reflect hua, because let me resume this. And now you can see this is a text field over here. And I would say I want to create a button. So yahan pe aapka jo button hai wo kya action perform karega. So I would say this button is just going to print a message, and that message is going to be hello and whatever name you have over here. So I would say self.name. So let me switch over here. So with this label, actually you can do a lot of style configurations, but right now what we are going to do is hum log sirf hamare button ka label print karenge. That is hamare button ka jo text rahega wo kya rahega. So I would say let me switch back, and I would say the text is going to be login. So as you can see, yahan pe login aa chuka hai. And right now the requirement is ki agar mera jo text field hai, agar usme 4 se zyada character, 4 ya 4 se zyada characters hai, to ye button enabled hona chahiye, warna ye disabled hona chahiye. So for that, what we can do over here is, rather than jis tarike se aapne imperative UI ke example mein aapne dekha tha ki hum logon ne text field delegate use kiya tha, in Swift UI you don't have to use anything like that. All you have to do is you have to use a function called as disabled, aur yahan pe aapko ek instruction pass karna hoga. And the instruction is, I would say if mera jo name hai uska jo count hai, if it is less than 4, then in that case what is going to happen is this button is going to remain disabled, as you can see over here. So right now, in order to test this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run the application, and I would say I'll just type RAV, abhi tak kuch hua nahi, and I would say I, you can see it is enabled. And when I type on login, so what happens is it prints hello Ravi. And now just let me go ahead and take one out, when one character out, you can see jo button hai wo fir se disabled ho gaya. To yahan pe hua kya hai, mujhe koi delegate implement karne ki zarurat nahi padi, just one simple instruction was enough for my button to enable and disable it. Now in the case of previous example, what we did is we implemented a UI text field delegate, aur yahan pe hum logon ne kya kiya, yahan pe humne specific instruction likhe ki what are the conditions jahan pe hamara jo button hai wo enable or disable hona chahiye. So you can see we have wrote some, you know, like specific code for that, but in the case of Swift UI this is not the case, and with just one simple instruction was enough for our button to enable and disable accordingly. Now this is the difference between imperative way of doing things versus the declarative syntax that Swift UI offers. Now Swift UI is pretty new, and jabhi bhi koi nayi technology ya fir naya concept release hota hai, there is obviously a learning curve associated with it, and there will be times when you will be frustrated, when you will not get the desired output, and that's okay because you're learning, right? And in the coming videos, what I'm going to do is I'm going to explain all the syntax that I have written right now in a much detailed fashion. Now this video was just to get you started with Swift UI. Now let's say if you have any questions, what you can do is you can reach out to me. You can find me on Twitter at CodeCat15. You can find me on my Facebook page, which is CodeCat15. And you can reach out to me at CodeCat15@gmail.com, which is my email ID.
I really hope you enjoyed this session. If you like the video, then please give a thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe. That being said, thank you so much for watching this. Have a nice day and happy iCoding. Bye-bye.